are the writings of the prophets to be received as the words of God himself. So hello and welcome back to this channel. Hope you're well, hope you're blessed. And today we are answering the question, are the writings of the prophet to be received as the word of God himself? So before we start this question and answering this question, let us say a word of prayer that we may invite the Holy Spirit into our midst. So let us pray. Dear Lord, we thank you and we praise you for this opportunity to come together. I pray that as David says, open thou our eyes that we may behold the wonderful things out of thy law. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. So to answer the question, are the writings of the prophets to be received as the words of God himself? We're going to turn to three chapters in the Bible, 2 Samuel, Jeremiah, and 1 Thessalonians. So in answering this question, we're going to start with 2 Samuel chapter 23, verse 1 and 2. And I've got my Bible here, you know, because even though as we're going through this series, I'm trying to learn as many Bible verses as possible. So hopefully by God's grace, you know, by the end of it, it won't just be also speaking, but we would also take time to study and to learn the word of God. So in answering this question, let us start with 2 Samuel chapter 23, verse 1 to 3. And it says, now these be the last words of David. David, the son of Jesse, said, and the man who was raised up on high, the anointed of God of Jacob, and the sweet psalmist of Israel said, the Spirit of the Lord spake by me, and his word was in my tongue. So the question is, are the writings of the prophet to be received as the words of God himself? And we see the answer is yes. The key verse in 2 Samuel chapter 23, verse 1 and 2 is verse 2, because it says here, the Spirit of the Lord spake by me, and his words was in my tongue. So the words of the Lord were in his tongue. So we can see that the Spirit of God was on his tongue. So the writings of the prophets are to be received as the words of God himself. So we see that this was David's account, but now let us see the words of the words in the book of Jeremiah. So in the book of Jeremiah, we're going to read Jeremiah chapter 1, verses 4 to 9, and answering the question, are the writings of the prophet to be received as the word of God himself? So it says here, then the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee, and before thou camest forth out of thy womb, I sanctified thee, and adorned thee a prophet unto the nation. Then said I, ah, Lord, behold, I cannot speak, for I am a child. But the Lord said unto me, say not, I am a child, for thou shalt not go all that I should send thee. And whoever I command thee, thou shalt speak. Be not afraid of their faces, for I am with thee to deliver thee, saith the Lord. Then this is the key verse for me. It says, then the Lord put forth his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord said unto me, behold, I have put my words in thy mouth. So the question is, are the writings of the prophet to be received as the words of God himself? So we see again a second witness in Jeremiah chapter 1 that the answer is yes. It says, behold, I have put my words in thy mouth. And the last book we're going to turn to is 1 Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 13, in answering the question, are the writings of the prophet to be received as the words of God himself? So we're seeing yes so far, and we're also going to see another witness in 1 Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 13. And I really love this verse, because when it thinks about, you know, preaching the gospel, when we preach the gospel as well, it should be from the words of God and not the words of man. And it's a blessing that we can trust the word. And as believers, we are to, you know, not only speak the word, but allow the word to speak in our lives so that we're also a living testimony. So it says here, For this course also we thank we God without ceasing, because when you received the word of God which you have heard of us, you received it not as the word of man, but as it in truth the word of God, which effectively worketh also in you that believe. So when they were preaching these words, it wasn't the words of man, but these were the words of God that were spoken when they were, you know, preaching the gospel. And also the latter part, which I talked about, and it says here, which effectively worketh also in you that believe. So the word of God is not just this talking, but the word of God is supposed to effectively work in us. It must be changing our lives. And I truly believe that as believers, we are to be reflecting upon our experience, saying, you know, Lord, have I grown in faith? Teach me what else I'm supposed to do. I want to grow more further in you. I want to grow more stronger in you. So the question was, are the writings of the prophets to be received as the words of God himself? And we have seen the answer is yes. We saw the answer was yes in 2 Samuel, and we saw that the word that they spoke was the words of God put in their mouth. We also see with Jeremiah, he had the same experience of as a prophet of God, that the words of God were put in his mouth. God touched his mouth and he anointed his mouth to speak the words of the Lord. And we also see in 1 Thessalonians with Paul, that as he's preaching the gospel, it's not the words of men, but it is the words of God, which has the ability to work in us to will and to do according to God's pleasure. So the answer in are the writings of the prophets to be regarded or received as the words of God himself. So the answer is yes, dear friends. So as we end this video in answering this question, my question to you, dear friends, is, do you regard the words of the prophets as the words of God themselves? And that is, you know, to be searched with God, because there may be times where you're doubting the words of God because, you know, it's been spoken by, you know, the prophets, the writings of the prophets, the writings which we have been so blessed to receive this day. So I'm going to say a prayer for all of us that God will forgive us for times when we have disregarded the words of the prophets, and God will help us to see that these are the words of God. We see, I believe it's 1 Corinthians, I don't know if it's verse 14, but it talks about how prophesying should be for the edification of the church. And God has given us these wonderful writings that we may take heed and that we may stand approved and prepare for these last days. So let us pray now. Dear Lord, we thank you so much because your word is inspired and your word is true. We ask that you please forgive us for any times we have disregarded the words of the prophets, the words that have been written for us for this generation. We ask in a special way that you'll please cleanse us, O God, and help us to see that the words that you have spoken are life and they have the power to change us. I pray right now that we would dedicate ourselves to you, that we would take time to read your word, and to remember that man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Be with us now and help us have a blessed week. In the name of Jesus, amen. So God bless and see you in the next video. And the next video on this series will be, are prophecies still important? So see you and God bless. Shalom.